teams have been introduced. Floyd County on the floor with their black uniforms. They're the traveling team, at least according to the bracket setup. They have the black uniforms, gold numbers and letters, gold trim along the side, the numbers and letters trimmed in white. Stonewall Jackson, their home white uniform. They have black numbers and letters trimmed in red. And just about ready to go and tip things off here at the Siegel Center. And one of these two teams will make it one game further than they did last year, Craig.
That's right.
Got bumped off in the semis, so ready to go. Womack and Hovatter will jump it up. Ball is controlled by Hovatter back to Jessica Richardson. And Hovatter gets the ball, and she wants to push. Lobs ahead to Bell. Wide open underneath. Layup is good. That's a good start. Yeah, 2-0 Generals. Nice look ahead by Hovatter. Boy, going to shoot a three from the corner. And that is short, no good. And a rebound as players hit the deck. And
Hovatter comes out.
She comes out. She wants to run. Comes back, and Floyd gets back. They knock the ball away from her. Stolen away by Brittany Adamsini. The shot at the other end, by the way, actually Tanner missed a three, and she has it now on the wing. Shot from the elbow is up, and that is no good. Rebound. Stonewall has it. Adamsini with the board. And back comes Hovatter looking to push. Split a couple of defenders down the lane. Wide open is Bell again. Shot is good. 4-0. Bell with a couple of layups. Still on the man-to-man. Out top. Shot a three. Rick, no good. And early on, Floyd County, which we heard was a pretty good shooting team, not very good. Coons in some trouble. Double team ahead. Gets it to Hovatter. She's down the lane. Dishes off to Richardson. Her layup off the glass. No good. Battle for the rebound. It's picked up by Shirley, and she gets fouled. Well, three looks, three-point blank shots, Craig, so... Well, Floyd has been doing a lot of reaching here out here at midcourt, and only once did they knock the ball away, but not playing very solid defensively. And almost was 6-0 if Richardson could have got that shot to drop in.
And you can't get a better look, that's for sure.
Here's the inbound. There's Bell underneath, wide open, lays it in again. Three layups, that one off the inbound. Back the other way. Adamsini driving, lost the ball out of bounds. Stonewall.
Well, Stonewall needed to get a good start.
6-0 our score. Full court press off the inbound. Coons having some problems. Does get it in towards Shirley over there, but knocked out by Brittany Avancini. Again, full court man for Floyd County. Have someone in the face of Coons looking to get it to Hovatter. She does have it. Here comes the double team. She spins along the sidelines, and up she comes. Getting double-teamed again. She's in trouble now. Finds Coons in the middle of the floor, and here comes Brittany going to dribble. She's to the free throw line, into the lane. Had her shot knocked away, but Connor Shirley got it back to Coons. 16-footer, no good. Richardson rebound. Had her shot blocked. It goes out of bounds. Oh, they say it went off Richardson. It was rejected by Amanda Epperly. I thought she hit it last.
But I did too, Greg.
Gives the referee the benefit of the doubt since he was standing right there. Lindsey Thompson. Avancini inside to Womack, looking to spin. Stop.
Nearly walked.
Kicks it back out. Ashley Tanner. And now back to Thompson. On the right wing. Looking inside. Can't get it there. Avancini at the point. Womack down low. Spins. Lost the ball. And a jump ball. Womack lost it. And then Coons reached in and tied her up. Jump ball. Floyd keeps it underneath. 6-0 Generals. 2 minutes and 2 seconds in.
And the one thing you have to wonder, if Floyd County hasn't had many close games, Craig, if you can keep it close against them, how will they react?
Well, inside Womack. Spin move in the lane. Shot up and good.
Floyd spin move.
Womack has 22 against J.J. Kelly. There's some reaching and bumping going on with Hovatter, but she gets away. A near steal, but she crosses half court. Lobs ahead for Coons. She drives into the lane. Over to Shirley. Her layup is good.
Now, Stonewall getting layups, Craig, so
breaking that press, not much problem. Driving down the lane, shot is rejected by Bell. They say they got her with the body, and that will send
Epperly.
Yeah, Epperly to the free throw line. It was a block and then the body contact by Molly Bell. But Bell got him. I don't think I've seen her jump that high during games usually. She usually doesn't go for blocks.
No.
But she did there. But
they don't want her to get in foul trouble.
No, they don't. Amanda Epperly free throw is good. three. Stonewall leads. Second one up. That one short. Rebound. Pulled down by Coon. Hovatter brings it up.
Three people waiting.
They're waiting for Hovatter, looking and does find Kuntz ahead. Kuntz on the dribble down the lane. Dishes off low. Bell can't control it. Shirley does. Saves nicely to Bell. She lost the ball. Back on Floyd. She walked and got away with it. Handed off comes up to Lindsay Thompson. She goes cross court. Here's a shot from 18 from the baseline. It's good. Ashley Tanner knocks it down and it's 8-5. Shirley takes the inbound. She'll dribble up ahead. Double teamed. Here comes pressure from behind, but Bell catches the deflected ball.
Just bumping, correct?
They really are reaching.
Not following anything.
There's a reach and a quick jump ball is called.
And they let us say this physical. It works to Floyd County's advantage, Greg, with that full court pressure.
Well, if we've seen anything, you can't reach in, but you can body block as much as you want. That's been the consistency that we've seen from referees this year. Coons looking to get in. Does out top for Shirley. Nearly had it knocked away, but got it back. She's in some trouble now. She picked up her dribble. Now finds Hovatter. Hovatter comes to her.
Finally get a push.
That was the least of all the bumps that we've seen so far, and that's going to be called on Brittany Avancini. That's the second on Floyd. Coons gets it in to Hovatter.
He almost reached in on her again.
Tries to get out of a double team, drives baseline, dumps it off to Bell in the lane. Nice dish to Richardson for the layup. What a pretty pass by Molly Bell. Back the other way. Floyd County. Shot from the key. It's blocked. Lindsay Thompson had her shot blocked by Coons. Shirley gets the loose ball. 10-5 general. Hovatter looks to direct some traffic. They're really trying to reach in on her.
He had her body and her tray just knocked her to the floor.
They knocked her to the floor. Ball comes loose. Floyd County gets away with it. At the other end, Thompson with a layup. Missed it. Womack gets the board. She puts it up and in.
I tell you what, they let this team be this physical, and that's not right, Greg.
Richardson tried to get the inbound pass, but it's stolen by Womack, and then she gets thrown for a travel. Floyd County fans a little upset, and I didn't really see the walk either.
Well, they missed enough of her walk, so.
Holly Brown comes in, and Womack comes out. Womack tore her meniscus back in December and really has been a shadow of what she has been.
Honestly,
here in the,
got knocked down again.
Here in the, ever since
knocked
then.
Out of bounds.
Inbound pass to Brittany Coons, or to Shirley, rather. She got knocked down, but Floyd knocked the ball out of bounds. Another substitution. This will be Samantha Gray checking in, and Lindsay Thompson will come out. 3:54 to go first quarter. Stonewall 10 and Floyd County 7. Coons looking to trigger in. Full court. Man-to-man press, and they like to double. Here comes Connor Shirley. Tries to get it ahead, but too far for Hovatter, and it's stolen away. A couple of turnovers here on consecutive trips.
Stonewall now has 4 and Floyd County 2.
Here's Epperly. Skip pass. It goes into the corner. Avancini with a spin into a double team. Kicks it out. Here's a 17 footer that's good. Molly Brown off the bench, and she sinks it. 10-9. Up ahead. Baseball pass to Shirley. She's looking to break. She gets bumped from behind. Threw a shot off the glass. Somehow it went in. Richardson got the board, and she gets fouled.
I don't know what you got to do to get a foul, Paul Craig, but
you got
to
hit him on the wrist.
I'll tell you what, this is a very physical game, and that plays into a team like Floyd County or Clark County's favor here, for that matter. Both of them like to press, and obviously don't care how many fouls are called because they go so deep.
So Jessica Richardson at the free throw line. It's short, no good. Richardson shooting about 71% here in the postseason from the line and averaging 3.2 points per ball game. Second attempt up, that one's good. Takes the margin to it, 11-9 for the Generals. Back comes Avancini. Puts on the brakes on the wing, and now back out top it goes for Ashley Tanner. She dribbles, and around the perimeter they swing it. Samantha Gray on the dribble now. Here's Avancini again at the top. Elbow, Molly Brown, jumper, good.
Well, I think you're going to have to get up on her, Craig. She's 6-2 in a row now.
Stonewall with the inbound. Shirley had the ball stolen away, and then she grabbed. Well, Connor Shirley has got to get rid of the ball as soon as she gets the inbound pass, or she's got to get the ball up the floor. She brought the ball down where Floyd could reach in and take it away from her.
Womack in, and Epperly checks out.
2:57 to go. Inbounds coming from Tanner. Floyd County has tied up the game. Here's Gray with
a
that's Brown with a shot that's no good. Way over the mark. mark, and Hovatter gets the rebound. There's another reach in, but the ball is knocked away by Ashley Tanner.
Well, now the game's going to be called now unless it changes in midstream.
Well, apparently you can bump and reach, too.
I don't think there's going to be many fouls today.
Well, so far not. Just three on Stonewall, two on Floyd. Or, sorry, the other way around. Coon. Out of Hovatter with 2:40 to play in the first period. Hovatter tried to go behind the back, had the ball stolen away by Ashley Tanner. She gets inside. Womack driving down the lane, a layup, missed it, rebound. Coon has it. Hands off to Hovatter, and Callie coming back.
That time Floyd missed the layup.
Coming half court, they are riding her all the way down the floor, and then there's a
car out of bounds.
But he stepped out of bounds. She got pushed out.
This is unbelievable.
They're going to let it go. Brittany Smith and Heather Stout coming in, and Molly Bell and Jessica Richardson are coming out, so the big girls get a break. 2:22 to go in an 11-11 game.
These guys are officiating a state tournament game?
Well, Floyd is, they're leaning on, they're putting an elbow up against whoever has the ball, and they're letting it go, so why not keep doing it? Top of the key, an ugly looking three.
Throw.
Somehow that went in. Samantha Gray
drained it, but it was, like you said, ugly.
Inbound pass stolen, taken away. Haven't seen him with the steal. Coons battles for the rebound. She got it back. Now she throws ahead to Hovatter. She's going to bring it into the offensive set. She gets tripped from behind, and that time they called it, and Kelly had a word about Samantha Gray for stepping on her heel. And we've known about Kelly Hovatter's ankle problem.
I guess they had to call it when she hit the deck, Craig. I don't know.
A minute 57 to go, 14-11. Inbound. Hovatter goes up high to get it. I'm blocked off. Somehow she got underneath to get a shot off, and no good. Rebound by Brown for Floyd County. She gets it to Thompson. She wants to push. Back out for a three. In and out. No good. Rebound Stonewall. Shot out. Missed by Thompson. Rebound indeed goes to Heather Stout. Haven't seen him. Starting Hovatter. Baseball pass ahead to Smith, who's down underneath alone. Stout has it underneath. There's a shot that was blocked.
That was Lisa's foul and less of a foul than we see out in midcourt.
Molly Brown gets called for the personal, but that was clean. Heather Stout will go to the line for a pair for the general. 1:29 to go, first period.
Heather struggled at the line this year, Craig. She's 9-20 right now. She has a better stroke than that, though.
Back of the iron, and it rattled out. No good.
Too much of a line drive. One more arc on it to drop it straight through. 1:29 remaining first quarter. Floyd County just moved in front, 14-11.
There she got the second one. 14-12. Buffaloes by a pair. Stonewall led by as much as 8-2. Out top. Here's a three on the way. No good. That one rimmed out. Battle for the board. Womack has it back up. Forced it in. Just outside south for that one. 16-12. Womack on the stick back of the Thompson miss. Hovatter to the ground, but she got the pass over to Shirley. She drives baseline. Her short jumper is good. 16-14. Buffaloes want to push it again. Haven't seen any driving. On Shirley, shot is blocked. A wild shot. Stout with the board. Looks to outlet somewhere and finally does to Coon. Now Hovatter, middle of the floor. 50 seconds to go. Hovatter into the key. No look pass. Too high for Shirley, but she saved it.
As he used the bell being down there. Craig Bell
had it. Stout reaches to get the loose ball. Now,
thankfully, threw it off of Floyd County.
Tries to get it to Shirley, but it was knocked out by
Tanner, taking her hand. I think she bent her thumb back on that one.
Ashley Tanner, one of those little stave jobs.
Yeah, those hang with you for a little while, too. Richardson and Bell checking back in for the generals as Smith and Stout go to the bench. Tanner still holding that thumb.
Inbounds for Coons with 39 seconds to go along the sideline. Gets it to Hovatter. Guarded closely by Avancini, who reaches and grabs and bumps. Hovatter fired something off the glass.
I don't know
so
if
that's
a pass or a shot.
I don't know, but it hit the bottom of the board.
Didn't work out.
Back comes Floyd. Tanner launches a long three. No good. Rimmed out. Connor Shirley underneath, and they say it's still on ball. Womack knocked it out of bounds.
22 seconds remaining in your first quarter. Floyd County 16, Stonewall 14.
Shirley takes the inbound pass, bringing it up. What a softer press this time. Crossover by Shirley.
Tired.
All the way down the lane. Pull up. Won't go. Rebound
no,
Molly Bell.
Got it.
She got it. She's double teamed underneath. And
we're going to call a reach in on that one.
Wow. Bell hurt, Craig. If anything happens there, it looked like Bell just fell down. She was double teamed, and Bell is down on her knee. Slow to get up. sign for the general. Looks like she's holding a knee or ankle or... But she did get double teamed. She got bumped.
I mean, so we've seen a lot of bumping going on.
Yeah, but she got herself in trouble by dribbling into the double team, though. But Stonewall has the ball back with 12 seconds to go. Inbound, Coons, Hovatter, tough shot along the baseline, partially blocked. And Floyd comes away with it. Back comes Thompson, looking to run. Down the side of the lane, throws up a shot, gets nowhere. Floyd gets the rebound, jumper in the lane, up and good by Amanda Epperly.
Horrible shot, turns out for a bucket.
Just before the quarter ends. So Floyd County was down 6 in the first part of this game, but they roar back to take an 18-14 lead after one period. We'll take a timeout and be back right after this. You're listening to Girls High School Basketball on Valley Sports Radio and WSVG. Back at the Siegel Center, one period in the book. Floyd County leads Stonewall 18-14. Buffaloes with the ball first here to start the period. Brittany Avancini trying to go down low to Womack. She does, driving baseline. Tough shot, but got it in. Nice up and under move. Again, full court pressure. Shirley got pushed. Yep, they did call it that time. Hand right in the back from Kristen Rogers. And that is the 16th foul on the Buffaloes. Or is it? Nope, that's the seventh, so it's 1-1. So Connor Shirley will shoot a pair here with the Generals down 20-14. They had an 8-2 lead early on, but Floyd closed that down and finally did take the lead. Actually went on a 12-3 run to go up 14-11, and they haven't given the lead back since. Samantha Gray's three put them up by 3 points. Shirley with a 1-1. Up and good. Connor Shirley's had some big games in the postseason. Only one over Northumberland. She was in some foul trouble, averaging 9.8 a game and 70% free throw shooter here in the postseason. Second one is all net. 2016. Back comes Floyd in a hurry. Haven't seen you looking to push.
Almost turned it over.
Top of the key is Thompson. Looks to drive inside Womack. Kicks it out. Here's a jumper from 16 feet. That's good. That's Kristen Rogers. And yeah, they can shoot a little bit. Yeah. Inbound, Hovatter coming up, crossover dribble, reaching in twice, they went back court.
They went back court.
Absolutely,
yeah, right.
Lindsey Thompson with a steal, went back court, then she spins
the ball.
Jeff Berner gets up and asks for the little forearm push to be called. 22-16. Shirley takes the inbound pass, here comes the double team again. She's looking
she
to dribble.
Wait for it.
Then she stepped on the sideline. Yep, she's got to catch it and go. Lucky she didn't get called for the hook.
Yep, she hooked her.
But she stepped out of bounds. Floyd County ball in a 6-point lead here in second period. Kristen Rogers with the basketball. Womack comes outside. She's going to crank a three. That's no good. Battle for the board underneath. It's saved by Floyd County. They've got it. Rogers with a shot up. No good. Bell pulls the board.
Had it. Lost it.
Hits the layup.
Yep.
Womack picks up the loose ball and hits it in. 24-16. Shirley looking for a get out of the double team and throws it away. Avancini with the steal. Womack, Avancini now. Goes into the corner for Thompson. Had a shot blocked by Brittany Coon. And Brittany will bring it up. She looks to get out of the double team. She has the ball stolen. There's a little ticky-tack foul caught on Womack, I think.
I don't know, Greg, but that was ticky-tack, and there's been bumping and pounding. And,
Well, Brittany Coons picked up her dribble just before half court. And just a little reach in on Womack, and that's going to be her second. And more free throws coming now for
Brittany. Informed the official that it's a 1-1. And so he's letting her go to the line now.
24-16. Floyd's lead is 8. And a hard free throw, but what a roll. Hit the back of the iron stick straight up in the air and went through.
Had just the right amount of backspin to go through, Greg.
I thought she was going to fire it off the glass as hard as it went up there. But it went in. Coons is averaging 4 points a game here in the postseason. Second free throw, much better, and that's a clean swish, 24-18. Coming back is Tanner of Floyd County. Avancini, top of the key. Three is on the way. Well off the mark, but a rebound. One time, back up and in. Tanner caught the rebound, and in one motion, put it right back in. 26-18. Hovatter, who's hardly touched the ball here in the second quarter, bringing it up. Pulls up at the elbow. Jumper, good. First point?
Yes, first point. Tally O'Batter.
26-20. Quickly back. Fires up a shot. That is the ugliest shot from Samantha Gray, but she's 2-2. 28-20. Koontz ahead for Hovatter. Lost the ball momentarily, but gets it back. And Floyd kind of,
everybody clear.
Kind of backs off. Now Hovatter's going to go to work. Crossover dribble. Kicks it out for Koontz, but
lost it.
Run away. Here's a steal, and they got a breakaway. Back the other way, and a layup is Will off the mark. No good, but the rebound is there by Floyd.
Right to Floyd.
Loose ball. Second chance. Third chance is in. Ashley Tanner with the stick back. And a timeout is taken by Jeff Berner. And the Stonewall Jackson Generals. It is 30-20. Floyd County's lead is up to 10. 30-20. Floyd County leading Stonewall Jackson here in the second period. And Randy, every time Floyd County has a chance, they're sending somebody to the offensive end. They're always looking to break away.
They certainly are, Craig, and that's part, I guess, their transition game. And they kind of sneak up on you. You feel like you're playing with them, and then all of a sudden you look up and you're 10 down like Stonewall. Right,
and
now
they do a good job of hitting the boards, too. Long inbound pass up to Molly.
Got a layup.
Has
throws
a
it ahead.
Her pass was deflected. Tried to get it ahead to Richardson, but Lindsay Thompson got back to deflect it away.
Well, if you saw Richardson earlier, she was there all by her lonesome, so just didn't see her quick enough.
Inbounds by Koontz, 5:34 to go in the period. Generals down 10. Koontz looking to trigger in. Still having some trouble. Gets it to Hovatter in the lane. Puts up a shot. Hit
bottom of the rim. No good.
Can't fit it in. Ball is loose. Richardson with a stick back.
That's
no good. And the rebound pulled by Avancini. She's looking to push. Here she comes. Cross-court pass goes. Fires hard. There's a shot rejected by Hovatter, but I think
now they're going to call a foul.
I think that was going to be on Koontz. Got her with a body.
Five on the hack.
And for Brittany Koontz, that'll be her first, and shooting free throws here is Samantha Gray. .521 to go, second quarter, and a thrown up free throw is good. That is one ugly looking shot, but she hasn't missed yet.
I guess they're not going to change it as long as you're getting the result.
That's one of those pitchers who has one of those funky motions. You say, as long as it works, keep doing it. Second one, that's up. That was way off the mark.
Wow.
Rebound. Shot back up. No good. And they got Richardson with the foul. Ashley Epperly got in there and ripped the rebound away from Molly Bell. And then Richardson came underneath of her. And back to the free throw line goes Floyd.
Their second. Epperly's been at the line once today so far. She's 1-2.
First one's up and in. Now 32-20. Epperly puts it up and good. 33.
Definitely a Floyd County pace, Craig.
33-20. Comes the inbound. Hovatter bringing it up the floor. She gets pushed. She dishes down low. Richardson off the glass and in. Floyd's not afraid. They're going to come up and put an elbow into you and give you a little bump and let you know they're there. Just got to overcome it. Here's Gray going down low.
Wow, that's a charge.
Avancini lowers her shoulder, puts the shot up, no good. Richardson skies to get the rebound for the Generals. She outlets to Shirley.
He used her arm to just push her away.
Now over to Hovatter, and she will bring it into the offensive set ahead of a double team. Here comes Koontz. She looks to go into a lane. She got away
with
a push.
There's a walk on travel early
on Connor Shirley.
That is turnover number 14 for Stonewall, Craig. I said they needed to keep it 10 to 15
yep
for the game, so they're going to be well over that.
Gone beyond that. 33-22, 4:45 to go in the first half. Thompson brings it up for Floyd.
Still on his own.
It's a three from the wing. That's no good by Ashley Tanner. Rebound, Molly Bell.
Might be in a zone to rest as much as anything.
Yeah.
They look a little tired right now.
Hovatter directing some traffic, trying to get away from a double team. Still dribbling. She drives, pulls up. Side of the lane, no good. Rebound underneath.
Surely had
four
it.
And coming away with it is Floyd. Avancini throws ahead. Brown and
it's off
out of court. Yep. Brown tried to save it and crashed kind of hard out of bounds. She's looking at her hand.
It's only the fourth turnover on Floyd County, Craig. Well, Stonewall's got 14.
Shirley takes the inbound. There's a reach.
Oh, boy. I don't understand, Craig.
Knocked out of bounds by Tanner.
Right across her body to knock it out.
Well, her with the chest, too.
Well, she had to hit her with the chest to reach across her body.
Well, Stonewall keeps the ball. The general fans behind us giving the referee right here in front of us an earful.
Wow, and he deserves it.
Hovatter with a spin move. Now Koontz. Skip pass to Shirley along the baseline. 4 minutes to go. Floyd Floyd by 11. Shirley with a tough shot. Rebound. Bell has it. This is out for Richardson. Her shot off the glass. No good. Rebound by Thompson. And back comes Floyd. Looking to push again. Samantha Gray. Out top for Thompson. Cranks up a three on the way. It's good.
Nice looking stroke on that one, Greg.
36-22. Inbound. Throw that ahead to Shirley. She palmed it. Got away with it. Another reach in. Knocked away. Back comes Floyd. Here comes Thompson working on Coons. Fall away shot. No good. Oh, they called Coons with the foul.
She held her position.
After a second, Thompson initiated the contact, but drew the personal on a fall away jumper from about 12 feet. Thompson, nothing good. And we have Kristen Rogers in, and Samantha Gray goes out. It was 26-20, and it's been an 11-2 run, and it's still 11-2 after the second free throw is no good. 37-22. Hovatter bringing it up, looking at a double and triple team. Lobs ahead for Coons. Coons, foul.
Yeah, they got her that time.
Got to be egregious on both ends.
Yeah, they're fine.
Unless you're reaching in. If you come close to get them on the hair of the wrist, they're going to call that, but Coons free throw good. Yep, you just have to adjust.
Well, you have to get just as aggressive, Craig.
That's true.
In college, you're going to have to do the same thing.
Both free throws good by Coons. 37-24. Back the other way. Quick three coming up. Thompson on the way.
It's good. He's got a good looking set, Craig.
Sure does. 40-24. Coons bringing it up. Going to push it up, and there's a whistle and a foul. And again, not much contact there. It was a block, but
we've seen a whole lot more contact.
Well, maybe they're going to start calling that. Maybe
it off, too. I mean,
maybe Jeff Berner has been working a little bit to try and get some of these fouls called, and Coons goes back to the line. But if they're getting two here, they can't combat the three at the other end. Lindsey Thompson has that perimeter shot down. First one good by Coons.
Someone may not be able to stay in that zone.
Second one up. That's a round and off. Rebound to Avancini for Floyd. Back comes Thompson. Lobs ahead. It's Gray. Sorry, that's Rogers. Again, Thompson for three. That's no good, but the long rebound comes out to
right
Tanner.
To Tanner.
She'll fire up a three. That's no good, and the ball sails out of bounds. Stonewall will get the orange. With 2:48 to go and a 15-point deficit they're facing.
Harvey Harlow checking in for the Generals. Richardson goes out.
So the smaller lineup. Inbounds to Harlow. She's going to dribble into the offensive set. Trying to cross over. Nearly lost it, but got it back down the lane.
Oh.
Threw it away. And a reach in. It's going to be called that Stonewall. Harvey Harlow. Well, I think if Harlow keeps her dribble alive, she can take it
now
right to
called it on Shirley.
She could have taken that drive right to the basket, I think. But
I think you're right, Craig. She just came into the game, so.
Stonewall Jackson would call, I think, a 30-second timeout.
Yeah, they will take a 30-second timeout.
40-25, Floyd County leading Stonewall Jackson. And only 2 points on the board for Callie Hovatter today, although she really hasn't been in position to score a lot of points.
They're trying to take her away, it looks like, Craig, and make her a passer. She does have 4 assists. Could have a couple more, but they missed the easy shot.
Stonewall going full court press now. And a
that's a walk.
Blatant walk. That's mid court by Lindsey Thompson. And she knew it.
Now that's only 5 turnovers against Floyd County in the first half. Stonewall Jackson already has 16, Craig. So
6 points for Connor Shirley and for Molly Bell. But they both have 2 fouls. Now here comes a trap, half court by Stonewall. Into the middle of the floor goes Hovatter with a shot. No good. Shirley up high for the rebound. Turn, spin, off the glass. No good. Bell gets it back and
riding for it.
And a foul inside.
Going to be on Epperly.
Hovatter had a good look from about 10 feet away. She should have banked it. She had the angle, but misfired. And Molly Bell, as always, fighting underneath, gets the rebound. And this will be double bonus, so 2 free throws here. Up and around and in. Second foul on Amanda Epperly for Floyd County, and she's going out right now. She'll be replaced by Brittany Bourne, a freshman, 5'9". 40-26, 2:17 to go, and Brittany Smith's getting ready to check back in. If Bell hits the free throw, she does. Stonewall will go out with the 2,000. 40 to 27. Again, Stonewall goes to the full court press here. And usually, the rule is the teams who press don't like to be pressed. I don't know if that applies to Floyd. Quickly back the other way, here's Ashley Tanner. And she had the ball knocked away from behind, and nearly a turnover.
Oh, better knocked it away, and Harlow dove at her, but didn't stop it from rolling out of bounds.
Almost saved it. Inbounds by Floyd underneath her basket, up by 13. Triggered in for Bourne, out top for Tanner. Man-to-man now for Stonewall. Thompson, pump fake, nice move. 15-footer on the baseline is good. She has a pretty
nice
shot. Thompson with a hoop. Hovatter driving back the other way, double-teamed, and they fall on her.
Right on her ankle.
Second time that somebody's fallen on her from behind. Avancini gets up and has a word with Hovatter. Hovatter says something back. Just a little friendly competition. Minute 54 to go. Generals trail by 15. Hovatter's free throw is short, but gets the roll. And drops in. Brittany Avancini comes out with the two personal fouls. She's replaced by Kristen Rogers.
Somehow, I don't think Floyd worries about fouls.
I don't think so either. They do shuffle a lot of players in and out. Second one's short.
Everybody stands there.
And Floyd does get the rebound, 42-28. Everybody's taking a breath. Thompson back the other way for Floyd. Rogers. There's Gray going down low. Bourne down inside. Had her shot blocked, but a reach-in going to be called on Brittany Smith. Is she... Fans are ground. That's all she has to do because it looked like Brittany Bourne was behind the backboard.
Wasn't a very good of an angle for a shot there.
So to the free throw line goes Brittany Bourne. 1-1. General fans in the, sorry, two shots. General fans jumped up trying to distract her, and the first free throw hit the back of the iron. I think that surprised everybody.
Bell back in for the Generals, and Smith goes out. A little offense defense switching going on here.
Second one by Bourne. That one's good. One out of two. 43-28. Floyd calls off the press. Go to his zone.
They double teamed somebody when they did this earlier.
Zone trap. Hovatter into the lane. She got fouled, and she will shoot two. Didn't know if they were going to call it, but a reach in on the shot by Samantha Gray. Gray really had no business going up there. She's 5'5", while Hovatter's about 5'10", and has a little bounce in her jump shot. Free throw by Hovatter. Short again, but caught the front edge of the rim. Back forward and dropped through. 43-29.
Randy Phillips has checked into the lineup for the Floyd County Buffaloes.
Second one by Hovatter. That's good. Two out of two. 43-31.
Smith back. Bell will go out.
I'm sorry. 43-30. 43-30, lead of 13 against Stonewall with some pressure in the backcourt. Tanner, into the offensive set for the Buffaloes. Driving, now stops, kicks it back out front to Thompson. Her skip pass across. Phillips and Rogers, then back to Thompson. Minute 15 to go, second quarter. 43-30, Floyd County. Tanner now on the wing.
That's got to be a record for passes in this first half.
There's a reach in by Barbara Harlow, and they're going to say jump or foul. They say foul on Harlow as she tried to reach in and tie up
early in this half. That would have been a jump, but it's going to be a free throws now.
So going to the line will be Brandy Phillips, a 5'5 sophomore.
Heard the buzzer. Here comes Bell back in. Smith will go out.
They do that offense defense switch.
And Bell's got the two personals. They're trying to protect her as much as they can. But they need her for offense.
Free throw good. Randy Phillips will get the bonus. Just relentless pressure. Always attacking. Second one good. Two out of two, 45-30. Down to a minute to play, second period. Kelly Hovatter asked for some help. She says, somebody in the middle of the floor, come on. Now she gets a screen. Still dribbling inside the key.
Nice pass
down low to Bell. Goes up at her. Shot blocked. Got it back. Forces it up off the glass. Won't go. Rebound underneath. And Floyd County comes away. Bell had a good look. Wouldn't go in. And I think Floyd might hold for one shot here.
Yep, she had a couple good looks.
There's Bourne. 35 seconds to go. Phillips, Thompson on the wing. Out top it comes down for Kristen Rogers. Knocked away by Shirley, but it rolls to Tanner. And just playing keep away, down to 20 seconds to go. Bourne at the top. Tanner on the wing. Out top now it goes for Rogers. Over for Thompson. Back out top for Phillips. Down low, nice pass. Thompson with a fall away. Left-hand shot won't go. Shirley gets the rebound with 8 seconds. Sorry, that's Harlow with the rebound. She looks ahead to Connor Shirley running wide open. Layup is good. She got pushed underneath just into the basket. Didn't let it go, and the horn sounds to end the period. Well, Floyd County ruled most of the first half. However, Stonewall goes out on a pretty good note as they stop him on the defensive end, and then nice look ahead by Barbara Harlow to find Connor Shirley for the layup. But Stonewall Jackson going to have to do something that nobody has done this year, not only beat Floyd County, but come back from a double-digit deficit. They trail 45-32 at the half, and we'll come back and recap after this timeout. You're listening to girls high school basketball. Another by Connor Shirley, as they were doing very well, handling the press well, not turning the ball over. And Floyd all of a sudden found their shooting, especially in the second half. They started lighting it up and creating turnovers as well. And they have jumped out to a 13-point lead here at halftime. The couple of runs that Floyd County went on, it was a 12-3 run there in the first quarter to go from down 8 to up 3. And then in the second quarter, it was a 20-16 game early on in the second period. And then they went on a 15-6 spurt to go up by 15 points, 37-22. Generals were able to shave a couple of points off of that. And that's where we stand at the break. 45-32, and yes, Stonewall fans, this is a halftime score. Lots of times you've seen your team play entire games with a score like this. Bounce pass intended for Hope, better stolen away. Up for Thompson, her left-handed layup is no good. Womack there with a rebound, back up and in. Not a good start.
Nope. There's another stick back.
And nearly another steal, as Avancini reaches in on
tried to turn into a defensive player and knock it away, but didn't do it.
47-32, Floyd underneath. Timeout by Jeff Berner right away. Didn't like what he saw right out of the gate. He's going to take a timeout right now. And maybe give a little earful to his team for a couple of turnovers in two possessions. You're listening to girls high school basketball here on Valley Sports Radio. Out of the timeout, jump ball, but the arrow goes to the Buffaloes. They keep it under their own basket, leading by 15. Thompson with some trouble getting it in, but does out front to Avancini. Lob inside to Womack. Spin move into the lane, jumper no good. Good rebound by Connor Shirley. She hands off to Hovatter, and Callie looking to push. Gets into the offensive set, around two defenders, driving, going all the way to the hole. Tough shot side of the lane, no good. In fact, it hit the side of the backboard, rebounded, back comes Floyd County and Avancini looking to run. Has Tanner on the left side. Layup no good. Rebound. Hold down by Stonewall. Connor Shirley lobs ahead for Hovatter. She runs it down on the sideline. Takes it towards the goal. Gets fouled. Cannot score. But she'll shoot a couple of free throws. So there the Generals beat Floyd County to the other end of the floor. Playing their game, basically. Floyd missed on one end, and they quickly got the ball back to the other end.
Dictated to them right now, Craig. They have to with being down 15 points.
Free throw by Ovatter, very short, no good.
Back to where the line takes a little bit of self-inventory, I think, Craig.
Yeah.
Regroup here. But he has been short on most of the free throws, but they bounced in.
Second one up. That one is short. Can't get the roll, but Richardson there with the stick back. She goes back up, had it stripped away. Bell comes away with the loose ball. Jumper no good. Richardson there with the board. Back up off the glass. Won't go. Tips for the rebound, and Buffaloes come away with it. Epperly pulls the board, and back comes Avancini looking to run. Kicks over to Tanner. Three on the wing. That's well short, but underneath is Avancini. Had her shot blocked. Ball tipped around. Womack has it for Floyd. Back up. Hit the underside of the basket. Got it back, and then she gets fouled. Well, basically, Womack threw the pass to herself. She just threw it up and hit the Well, didn't he make it to the rim? It hit the net. She got it back and drew the foul. That's Bell. That's her third. Womack's free throw is good.
Well, Craig, they got enough opportunities that time. You know, both teams did really. Actually,
yeah.
Stonewall had a lot of shots down at the other end and failed to capitalize.
Free throw no good. They say Womack stepped over the line. 48-32 is a 16-point lead for the Buffaloes, the unbeaten Buffaloes of Floyd County, who continue with their full court press now. Inbound pass is deflected away, and there's Avancini with a throw down low, and it's a hold on Connor Shirley. That's going to be her third. The third period here in the postseason have been when they have just dismantled teams. And they're up by 16 right now. Inbounds to Tanner, goes inside to Womack. Spin move, and then cross-court pass. It goes Avancini, driving wall. Baseline, shot up, no good. Richardson pulls the board for the Generals. Connor Shirley is going to bring it up. She stops, makes a spin move, and she goes. They reach, no call. She keeps going into the lane. Pull-up jumper from about 10 feet, no good. Womack pulls the board for the Buffaloes and lost it. Hovatter comes up with it. She drives.
She
gets fouled, and the shot
still
wouldn't
get it to go.
Shot wouldn't go. So she'll go back to the free throw line where she just missed two. Stonewall Jackson, even though they don't really want to play at this tempo, that they pretty much ever since the opening gun have been playing that way. I mean, they're not adverse to playing the up-tempo game, but Floyd's just been a little bit better. Again, Hovatter's free throw rattles out.
And that one right on just came out. Harlow and Smith going to check in for the general.
That one's around and in. One out of two. 48-33. Richardson and Bell out, and Harlow and Smith do indeed check in. 6:20 to go, third period.
Yeah, he's trying to protect Bell, plus get a little quicker lineup in maybe for the press, right?
Yep, and they do have a soft press on as Tanner brings it up. Here's Avancini on the left wing. Inside Womack, spin move up and under. She gets fouled by Smith.
That was unnecessary because he didn't have anywhere to go either, Craig.
She hits the deck hard and she'll go to the line. Well, Hovatter, I think Randy had something on Saturday when you said she didn't look quite herself against Northumberland, and perhaps that ankle, which she injured in the district tournament game, could be still bothering her.
Coach Burner told me that it still does bother her at times, so she's been playing with that, and both of us noticed that the pull-up jumper in the lane, which is her favorite shot, has been short ever since that, and you don't get quite the lift. But she's not going to come out of any game, Craig, unless you carry her off.
Womack makes them both. It's 50-33, lead up to 17. Shirley, middle of the floor to Molly Bell, had her pass stolen away in a reach, and a foul going to be called on Connor Shirley.
Well, all of a sudden, number 11 has become a magnet for the whistle. That's her fourth.
That is her fourth. And again, it's the reach-in which gets the whistle. Looks like she got a considerable amount of basketball, but she'll head out with the four fouls. And Barbara Harlow's going to have to come in. That takes away another offensive presence.
And that's 15,000 on Stonewall already here in the second half. Just over 2 minutes in.
Avancini out top. Epperly, Thompson, and Tanner with a three. Top of the key is good. Just about everybody can knock down that perimeter shot. Here's a steal by Floyd, and ball knocked out of bounds by Hovatter. Floyd with a basketball.
21 turnovers now for Stonewall, Craig, so 20 points down, too. So 5:39 to the third quarter, 53-33, Floyd County. Boy.
Thompson
got away with a shove in the back.
Double teamed. Here's Avancini with a jumper from 15 feet. No good. Bell had the rebound taken away from her. May have been over the back on Epperly, but she missed the shot. Rebound to Bell. Back comes Hovatter. Looking to weave through the defense. She does. Pull up from the elbow. That's good.
That's her favorite shot. There's a swift
shot. She knocked that down. Quickly back is Floyd. Down low. Womack had the ball go right off her foot and out of bounds.
Has only 7 turnovers now against Floyd. Stonewall has 21 meanwhile, so.
Hovatter with the inbound. Here comes the double team. She gets rid of it to Koontz and ahead for Harlow. She'll bring it into the offensive set. Has a 3-on-2. tried to force a pass, and Womack with the steal, and then Harlow with the reach.
Well, had to break Craig. She could have just kept going to the hole with
yeah.
it, but she gave it up too quickly. And they kind of backed off of her. If she pulls up, she's got about a 12-foot jumper in the lane.
53-35. Floyd back the other way, and they'll be shooting free throws here soon. Womack inside. Spin move. Gets double teamed. They're going to call what?
Sound bell. You watch me.
And a push inside on. Yep, it's Molly Bell. And
that's going to be her fourth.
That's her fourth. So as physical as the game's been, the foul trouble is mounting for the Generals rather than the Buffaloes, although they do have a deeper rotation. Although Avantini does have three for Floyd County. 53-35, Womack to the line. .455 to go in the third period. Free throw in and out, no good. Ball is kept in control by the Generals. Hovatter behind the back dribble. Now she gets bumped by Womack on the sidelines, and she turns to the bench and says, "That's four on me." Well, she just was fouled. That was pretty blatant there, and she'll be replaced. Molly Brown comes in.
Differences. It doesn't hurt the Floyd County at all,
no.
Right? Because Brown came in and did very well in the first half. Had two jumpers.
It's like Floyd's in his own. Hovatter down the lane. They call it for a walk as she came to a jump stop. Tried to split a double team.
Well, the officials and everyone from Floyd County saw it, Craig. So
yep.
A little bit of a travel.
Haven't seen any on the right wing. Floyd County leading 53-35. Out top, Avantini, a long two. That's good. Brittany Avantini. 55-35. Inbound for Harlow. She's double-teamed. Tried to pass it back to Coons, but it's saved by Floyd County underneath, and a foul on Brittany Coons. As she hits Brittany Avantini, that'll be two shots coming. And now all of a sudden, Harlow with the foul trouble.
18 fouls on Stonewall now.
Timeout has been called by Jeff Berner. He wants to take another timeout, go over some things. 4:17 to play third period. Floyd up comfortably now by 20 points, 50-35 over Stonewall Jackson. Floyd County 55, Stonewall 35, and Brittany Avantini going to the foul line. Board shows her with 2 points on the day.
And that's correct.
And that just came a second ago. On a long jumper. Free throw is no good. I'm sorry. That was
Avantini ready for her second.
Yep. Second one is good. One out of two. 56-35. Pressure continues. Brittany Coons. Had the ball knocked away. Nope, just lost it right out of bounds. Another turnover.
Now that's nine in this quarter, Craig. 25 in the game now, so they're rapidly approaching what they did against Clark County, that region final game.
Here's a jumper from the baseline that is no good.
Harlow has it knocked away from behind, but goes to Hovatter.
Molly Brown missed the shot, and back comes Callie Hovatter looking to break, looking to drive. Spin move into the lane, got bumped, no foul. Rebound to Floyd. Back the other way comes Avantini looking to run down the lane. Layup did good. Took it coast to coast. 58-35. 23-point lead for Floyd County. Hovatter dribbling down the lane. Shot is around. No good. One shot and out. Back the other way comes Floyd. Thompson on the dribble. Back out top for Avantini. A long two on the way. That's way off the mark. And Stout goes up to get the rebound. And a little reachy, touchy foul there. Going to be called on Amanda Epperly. She rolled her eyes at that call as well. And we have Samantha Gray checking back in for the Buffaloes. And Lindsay Thompson goes out.
Thompson is one of the sweetest strokes you'll see. And Gray was one of the most unorthodox shots you'll ever see. But they've both been effective today.
Stout trouble getting it in, does get a bounce pass into Hovatter, who stopped along the sideline, double teams over to Stout, now Coons. As they reverse it, stand up the floor, she brings it. Coons looking to drive, double team,
knocked away,
reached in, she hits the deck, Hovatter picks it up, she takes it to the goal, gets bumped, missed the shot, no good, now reach, knocked to the floor, was Amanda Epperly, but she gets called for traveling. Well, she's got to feel like she's being picked on here all of a sudden.
Yeah.
58-35. Generals with the ball, but down by 23. Hovatter drives into the lane. Up and a double team missed it. Got the rebound. Back up off the glass. That won't go. Richardson the stick back. That won't go. Generals have 3 points this period. 13 for Floyd. Quickly ahead. Haven't seen him with a foul in the basket. Down by South. Couldn't stop her from scoring the layup. And allowed her to score and fouled. Haven't seen any chance for the three-point play. Free throw, no good. Rebound. Stick back up, no good by Amanda Epperly. Richardson had the ball, lost it. Shot back up off the glass by Gray, no good. And Coos gets the rebound for Stonewall. She gets to midcourt. She's double-teamed. Stepped in between and a whistle and a foul in there, I guess, somehow. Somebody got her across the arm. I think they got Thompson. Rodgers is in now for Floyd. Epperly goes out. Foul. They've got
zone defense now.
And they're trapping out of the zone. There's a pass.
Throw
going away. Going back the other way and a push from behind. Going to be called on Brittany Coons.
She acts like she didn't foul, Craig, but she did.
Yes, she bumped her.
She had her arm in her back.
From behind, Samantha Gray made the steal, and she'll shoot a couple of free throws now for Brittany Coons. That'll be her third. So 60-35, and again, Floyd County has been their office, their modus operandi, has been pulled away in the third quarter. First free throw good. Only 3 points for Stonewall Jackson here in this quarter. A free throw and a basket by Callie Hovatter.
Thompson in, Tanner out. Barbie Harlow coming in for the Generals. And Heather Sound going to go in.
Second one coming here for Samantha Gray. 5'5 senior. Free throw up. She was over the line, I think, but she made the shot.
Right.
This time, it was called earlier, but not this time. 62-35. Inbound. Still with the pressure is Floyd. Still trying to double team, and Hovatter dribbles away from it. Comes down on the break.
Knocked away from behind.
And a reach in on Barbara Harlow.
Down on Harlow.
Well, the Generals here last year finished the semifinal game with only four players on the floor. And they're already in foul trouble here, although they do have a much deeper bench than last year. At least number of players.
221 left in the third quarter, and now they're in the double bonus already.
Yep. So it'll be Lindsey Thompson. Four fouls on Barbara Harlow. First one good. Avancini is out, and Brandy Phillips comes in. Well, no doubt Floyd County was determined to get back to this game. I'm sure they will be kind of rooting for Gate City, I would think, to try and exact a little revenge over the last 2 years. Both free throws good by Thompson. There's Hovatter. She draws a crowd that dribbles into the offensive set, top of the key. Again, hands all over, but they let them play. 64-35. Hovatter looking for a screen and gets it. Again, elbows and forearms right into her. She floats into the lane. Shot is up and around and no good. Wouldn't fall. Floyd gets the board.
Back. It's like a hockey check.
Thompson ahead. Samantha Gray has a shot rejected by Hovatter and it calls for a foul. Got her with the body. Now the referee says got her across the arm. Now, if there was a foul, it was on the body. It wasn't across the wrist. I think everybody here saw that. So Gray goes back to the free throw line, where she knocks the first one in. Well, most of Floyd's points this quarter have been coming at the free throw line.
Yeah, Stonewall shouldn't be so physical, Craig.
Yeah, they're just reaching and bumping like crazy, aren't they?
Well, I know they've got at least 11 team fouls now.
Gray's second one gets the roll, two out of two. 66-35. Again, with the full court pressure, Connie Shirley has checked back into the game. Comes back on the other end. Bell, she gets the dish and scores off the glass. 66-37. That is a long drought. I'll see if I can add it up here. Back at the top of the key, and there's Lindsay Thompson open, and she knocks down the tray. 69-37. Inbound to Hovatter, back to Coons. She'll bring it up out of the middle of the floor. Little bump, little reach. Molly Bell gets the loose ball. Pump fake and a whistle by the guy about 35 feet away. Calls a foul on Floyd underneath. Two now for Molly Bell. Foul is on Brown. So Molly Brown fouled Molly Bell. Free throw is up and that's good. Second one up. That's good. 69-39. A minute 23 to go, third period. Floyd County is up comfortably by 30 points. Their lead was 13 at the end of the half, and they have stretched it out. Oh, whoops. Thompson went to make a pass to, I believe, Molly Brown, and Molly Brown had turned her head. She turned her head and was headed towards the baseline, and to travel on Thompson. Hovatter, again with pressure. Here's a long two by Coon from the left wing. That's no good, but right to Molly Bell for the rebound and the stick back. 69-41. Back comes Floyd again. Tanner goes down low. There's a shot that's sneaked in by Kristen Rogers. Got a good bounce off the rim, and now here's another poke away by Floyd County from behind. Back they come the other way. Here's a long two-point shot that just barely draws iron from Molly Brown, and rebound by Coons. Down to 38 seconds here, third period. Hovatter with a cross over dribble behind the back, and now spins away from another player, jump stop, dishes off for Richardson. It got knocked away, and the Molly Bell gets fouled and scored.
Well, wasn't the way it was planned, but it worked out right.
Wasn't the prettiest way to get a basket, but they got it. The bell to the line. Stands for a three-point play. That's good. 71-44. Back comes Floyd and Thompson whistle, and Floyd wants a timeout with 26 seconds left. We're going to keep it right here at the 30-second timeout. Interesting that he's going to call timeout here with a 27-point lead at 71-44.
He's checking Womack back into the game, but
she has those four personal fouls.
I think it's emergency credential time yet, but 71-44, 26 seconds left in the third quarter. Stonewall Jackson, not enough firepower to keep up here, Craig.
Well, Floyd County, solid on both ends of the floor, pressure defense. Good shooting team offensively. And creating a lot of turnovers from Stonewall Jackson today. Pretty confident-looking team. Well, and you would imagine, since they've been to this tournament here a number of years, and Alan Cantrell is a longtime coach for the Buffaloes. He's been here before, been here as a champion. All right, after the timeout, down to 16 seconds, Buffaloes with the ball. Here is Adrian Womack on the dribble between the circles, down to 10 seconds.
They just tried to get her down low since they brought her in.
She's at the front foul line now. Tough jumper, fall away, no good. Coons underneath, had the rebound. Had it knocked away with 1 second left. Don't think she'll get a shot off. She will not by the end of the period. So we go to the fourth quarter with Floyd County cruising past Stonewall 71-44. Take a break and be back after this. You're listening to Girls High School Basketball on Valley Sports Radio and WSBG, Mount Jackson, Virginia. Eagle Center in Richmond, and fourth quarter starting. Stonewall trailing 71-44 over the Floyd County Buffaloes, the number one don't know if they're... Yeah, there's only 6 seconds off the clock. Should be much more than that. Because Stonewall had the basketball for a possession, and then Floyd came back, and I would say maybe about an extra 10 seconds should come off the clock. Just guessing. 71-44. Those of you who want to listen online to ValleySportsRadio.com, we will have Clark County boys coming up next. Yeah, exactly 10 seconds come off the clock. Good call. I got one right tonight. Clark boys taking on James River. James River is undefeated. Taking on the defending champion Clark County Eagles. And then also online, we'll have Clark County.
The clock. Hovatter tries to dish down low. It went off a couple of hands, and they say it went off Floyd. Callie Hovatter so far was only 8 points tonight, Craig. So, and she has a double-digit scoring streak going, doesn't she?
She certainly does.
She dribbles into a double team, dishes out to Richardson, back to Hovatter.
85 games in a row.
Callie into the lane. Tough shot. That
there
one goes
go.
In off the glass. 71-46. Back the other way. Ashley Tanner. Jumper fires it off the glass. No good. Rebound. Run down by Lindsey Thompson for Floyd. Haven't seen any in the corner, driving baseline. Spin move, bench is traveled. Yep. Turnover to the Generals, 7:09 to play.
Pressure still being applied.
Still pressing full court with a 25-point lead. Looking to trap, too, and there's a little bump on the sideline. And Thompson knew she threw a hip into Hovatter, and are they shooting yet? Yes,
yep,
they are.
They are now.
That run in the third quarter, it was a 45-32 lead at halftime, and it was a 21-3 run for the Buffaloes after that to put this game pretty much out of reach. Hovatter's free throw is good. Hovatter gets her bonus. Callie came in averaging 21.9 points per ball game. Got them both. 71-48. Pass along the baseline for Molly Brown. Back out top for Tanner.
Thought about it.
Haven't seen any dribble the ball off of her foot, and ahead it comes for Hovatter. She's going to try and beat some Buffaloes down at the other end. She drives into the lane. Scoop shot, missed it, got a rebound, and battle for the rebound, and haven't seen it. Comes away with it. Back comes Floyd, and they got a break. Nobody back. And a layup by Gray. Samantha Gray is good. 73-48. Connor Shirley comes back. She gets knocked to the floor and a foul called. Foul on Rogers. Nope. 00. Avancini. That'll be number four on the Floyd County point guard, so she will go to the bench. And Connor Shirley goes to the free throw line. 8 points tonight for her. Free throws up. That's short. No good. Rebound. Floyd comes away with it. Up ahead comes Floyd. Have a two-on-one break. Actually, the ball was kicked by Connor Shirley. So the ball on out underneath to the Buffaloes. 6:28 to go, fourth quarter. Inbound by Thompson. Out top for Tanner. Three on the way. No good. Rebound. Hovatter underneath. Nearly lost the ball, but got it back. And still Floyd Kelly with the pressure. Long look ahead. Molly Bell wide open. Has a layup. It's good. Good look. Three-quarter court pass by Hovatter. 73-50. Here's Gray. Thompson. Long two on the way is no good and out of bounds by Molly Brown. Missed everything. That's the worst resulted shot tonight. I'd say it's the worst looking shot that they've thrown up this afternoon, but some of the ugly looking shots have gone in. Hovatter takes the inbounds and ahead she comes. She gets it to Connor Shirley into the offensive set, into the middle of the floor for Hovatter. Spins now back into the lane. A runner up off the glass. It won't go. Halfway down. Bell had it taken away, and now Richardson reaches in and forced a jump ball. That's a bad call. Molly Brown, it should have been a jump between Brown and Richardson. Floyd County fans react likewise. 73-50. Generals trailing, but with the basketball. Coons looking, close to five, but gets it into Hovatter back to Coon, something under move in the lane, had a shot blocked, but Bell chases down the loose ball. Out top for Connor Shirley. She goes to Hovatter into the lane. Nice dish
pass
across to Richardson for the layup. 73-52. Along the baseline, Samantha Gray. Into the corner, back out front for Thompson. 5:25 to go. Thompson for Tanner. Looking inside, does get down low for Brown. Tough shot. Hit the underside of the backboard, and the loose ball picked up by Coons for the Generals. Looking to push back. Driving along the left side all the way to the hole. Nobody stopped her, but missed the shot. Hovatter gets the board. She goes back up, and she's fouled. Well, the Generals have had they would have a few more possessions earlier in the second half, the way they've had here in the fourth quarter. Well, they might be a little more competitive here tonight.
Yeah.
But the turnovers, you know, you're giving away chances, a chance to play the game at your pace when you give it to the other team. First free throw by Hovatter is good.
Womack and Everly back, and checking out of the lineup is Brown and Rogers. For the Buffalo, 73-53, 20-point lead for Floyd County, 5:10 remaining.
Second one no good, and Womack pulls the board. For the Lady Buffaloes, 73-53, 5 minutes to go. Thompson with a three. It's way off the mark, and the rebound kicked around
all over the place.
Womack comes up with it for Floyd County, and it will back it back out. Lindsey Thompson for Epperly in the corner. Tanner down low. Womack lowered her shoulder right into Richardson, and now, oh, they got a foul?
There's no way they can call a foul on that.
Well, Bell came over to double team, and let's see if they're going to get Richardson or Bell.
Well, they called Bell. There's no way. If anyone got her, it was Richardson, but I think she got Richardson called for a charge.
Molly Bell with 19 points is just fouled out of this game. There's 4:44 to go. And of all the bumps and shoves and elbows and forearms that have gone on out there, she's called, well, a couple of times for some little reaches where she's tried to double down. But again, it's been that way on both ends of the floor. Free throw by Womack. Back iron, no good.
More like hockey out of center court.
Yeah.
You can get out here and use your forearms or whatever you want to.
Womack's second one coming. That is good. Her 16th point of the game unofficially. 74-53. Hovatter back. Here's an attempted pass to Smith that got knocked away. And Womack, she traveled.
And oh,
they called
foul.
On Smith. She took two steps and then maybe got fouled. Well, they have mixed crews here. They all had different logos on.
Yeah, it doesn't matter where they come from, Greg.
And it hasn't really mattered tonight, has it? Or at least in this first game. 4:36 to go, and Womack back to the free throw line. Shot is up and good. So the lead has been as much as 30 points. I think that's as high as it got. So we'll close it down to 66-35 was the biggest.
Okay,
31. They cut it down to 20. And now back up to 23 as Womack makes them both. And still the pressure continues for Floyd County. Win with an exclamation point, I guess. Here's Smith as she gets the pass ahead of the break. Reverse layup by Hovatter. Up around, wouldn't go. Rebound Shirley with the stick back.
It
That's off the
go.
Board miss. Richardson again. This time it's good. 76-55 against Floyd County. Continues to push the ball up the floor inside, and a shot up no good. Smith blocked the shot by Epperly. She got it back. Tanner now on the dribble on the wing. 4 minutes to go, 76-55. Floyd cruising past Stonewall. Here in the state semifinals from the Altel Pavilion at the Siegel Center. VCU, Coons reached in with a steal and took it right away from Thompson. Nice play. And now Hovatter will bring it up. Baseball pass ahead. It goes to Connor Shirley. She drives. Her shot is no good. Smith had the rebound.
Lost it. Richardson got it.
Kicked back in by Jessica Richardson. 76-57. Quickly back to Womack. Spin move in the lane. Shot blocked by Hovatter, but they're going to call her with a foul.
Richardson working her jaw, Craig. I don't know if she got hit or something, but she's working her mouth around a little bit.
11 points.
Too many bodies to see in there at that point.
11 points now for Richardson, and this is a kind of game we expected out of her a lot this year. Free throw is good by Womack. Well, a lot of teams in the district are, you know, they know to try and take away as much as they can from Richardson. So, you know, they can stop one, but they haven't been able to stop Bell and Hovatter. And these are the type of games that they spread the floor, and Hovatter is able to penetrate and get some rebounds. Richardson is, and she can put some points up on the board. 77-57 as one out of two free throws by Womack. Hovatter gets away from a triple team. Koontz down the lane. Has all stripped away. And back comes Floyd County. Samantha Gray going to drive all the way to the goal. Again, Hovatter comes and blocks that one. And that one's clean, they say. No foul. Ball.
Third leg whistle, Craig. So he's looking around.
Now to get a sub in as Gray goes out. And Brittany Avancini comes in. 3:12 to go. Thompson triggers into Avancini.
She nearly walked on that.
I think she did shuffle the feet.
Looks like it.
Avancini gets it back as they play along the perimeter. And a whistle and... What was that for?
An illegal screen? Illegal screen, but I didn't see it, frankly.
I didn't even see a screen being set, and I think they got Amanda Epperly again.
Seems like they got one number in their mind, Craig, and they...
It is her fifth. So, again, away from the ball, and she's disqualified, and Molly Brown will replace her with 3:04 to go, and a 20-point lead for Floyd County. 3 minutes remaining. Still, the pressure continues. Hovatter gets away, crossover dribble, working on Thompson. Pass ahead is deflected away, and Floyd comes away with it. Avancini lobs it ahead for Tanner. Dishes across the lane, and the block shot by Hovatter, but a foul, and Thompson will shoot a couple here. And they got...
They got their fourth. I've only got three.
That's all I have. That's all they have on the board as well. Free throw is good by Lindsey Thompson. Yeah, they're just flashing three on the board for Hovatter. 13 points tonight. Thompson free throw, that's good. She has 16 points. 79-57. 2:45 to go. Koontz brings it up. Again, it's a reach in and a steal. Avancini comes away with it.
I think Koontz is trying to foul her back there.
And there's Collin. Koontz was all over Avancini, no call at all. Hovatter with the steal ahead to Brittany Smith. She's got a layup. Missed it. She slapped the floor. She had a wide open layup and missed it. Avancini coming back the other way. She drives in the lane, kicks it out. Tanner with the three in the corner. That's good. 81-57. Well, Koontz did all she could to knock Avancini through the floor on that last trip.
Oh, they throw it right to
and second straight time with a steal. Koontz, Avancini driving, throws up the shot and gets fouled by Richardson.
That's Richardson's first foul, sir. I guess it's almost unbelievable.
Really?
You're right. I have to look up and see because that's what I put one by her name. I look at the school board and it is her first.
82-57. And Avancini's free throws around and off. And Lindsey Thompson and Molly Brown go out. Kristen Rogers and Brandy Phillips come in for Floyd County with 2:06 to play. Second one, that's good. 83-57 as she gets one out of two. Stonewall had an early lead of 8-2, and then Floyd went a 12-3 run to take control. They led by 4 at the end of the first period, led by 13 at the break, and then poured it on in the third quarter and pulled away. Hovatter with a runner, no good. Connor Shirley gets fouled, and
she didn't get fouled. She got blocked.
She'll shoot a couple of free throws, but and that's been a running theme also today.
Yeah, we've
57, and that's going to be 5 now on Brittany Avancini. So Connor Shirley to the stripe. And a big hand for Brittany Avancini, the sophomore guard. As the Buffaloes will celebrate and get ready to play on Saturday against either Clark County or Gate City. Shirley's free throw is no good. Just a second. Minute 52 to go. Second one by Shirley. That's short as well. Ball is tipped around, and Richardson comes away with it. A dribble. Had the
knocked away.
Ball knocked
back.
Away.
Hovatter's got it.
Hovatter out
up.
Of the double team gets fouled and scores.
They're going to call the foul number 30. I think it was Womack, but they're going to give it to 30. At least that's who they pointed at. Rogers.
Kristen Rogers. Count the basket.
No. I don't know who he called.
They called Selena Hollingsworth.
She wasn't even there.
She just checked in unless she reached in. Womack comes out. She also gets a standing ovation from the Floyd fans right behind their bench on the far side. Hope had her chance for the three-point play. And she gets it. 83-60. And Marcy Bell comes in for
Richardson.
Jessica Richardson. And Stonewall's going to go a little full court pressure here. They say, hey, if you're going to keep on, we will too.
As a carry.
Tanner brings it into the offensive set for the Buffaloes.
We haven't had our carry today.
No, we haven't. Nor a 3-second call, have we?
No.
And they're letting everything else go, so why not that?
Well, speaking of 3 seconds, Floyd's just standing in there. 42.
Yeah.
Just camping.
Rogers with a jumper from 15 goes no good. Coons gets the board for the Generals. Lost the ball, now picks it up. On the floor, pass out front, and Marcy Bell picks it up at half court. Hovatter ahead. Shirley
unbobbles it. She's got to win the wall.
Well, I saw a bobble. I didn't see if she
shuffled
the feet.
But maybe they're saying she didn't have possession of the ball.
83-62. Here's Selena Hollingsworth. And now up top. Down low they go for Porn. She lost the ball. Out top for Tanner. And around they swing it. Phillips and pass out of bounds intended for Hollingsworth. Stonewall gets the ball with 54 seconds to go as they trail by 21. And substitution for Stonewall Jackson is Jessica Schenck. Makes her appearance here in the state tournament. She's a 5'1 sophomore.
50 seconds, clock running, Craig, and Stonewall season's going to end at 23-5.
And end again at the state semifinals. Here's Koontz, then Hovatter on the left wing. Drives baseline, pull up jumper, 14 feet around and in. 83-64. Final 30 seconds of the contest. Tanner ahead. And a whistle, and Floyd County wants a timeout. I think he wants to get his subs in here. Sub, a sub in for the timeout.
The only girl that hasn't played, and she's got a bad leg, right? She's been sitting on the bench the whole time.
Yeah.
She's got a brace on her knee.
So, Kayla McAlexander has, I don't even think she took part in warm-up, but she was dressed out. And
I think he's just explaining to her what he wants her to do. I'm sure he doesn't want her running or anything.
No.
Probably just telling her to stay right here. Go down here and stay here. At least, you're in the game.
So she wants to at least, Coach Allen Cantrell wants to at least get her name into the book as playing. And, you can see she's walking gingerly on that left leg. Kayla McAlexander, 5'4 junior. She will inbound the ball with 26 seconds to go. Looking to get it in, and she does, to Brandy Phillips.
I'm sure they'd like to get her a shot, Greg, but
she's not moving too much.
No, she can't.
Are you kidding me? 30 feet away from the basket, Floyd not looking to score.
No.
He called Smith with a reach in.
All I can say, that's eagle eye over there.
I mean, that. Yeah, it was right in front of the ref, but it was unnecessary.
He's let the hockey check go midcourt, and then he calls that.
I mean, there may have been a little contact, but come on, there's 18 seconds left.
Hey, he's not worried about it. He's only got one game today, so I hope he's only got one. Let's put it that way.
Kristen Rogers makes the first.
Well, the officials didn't cost anybody this game,
no.
But at state level, you certainly expect.
And the team has come out, Brittany Koontz and Callie Hovatter, and the fans stand and applaud their effort and how they have played for this team over their four-year career. Free throws are good. Kristen Rogers makes them both, 85-64. And here's Jessica Schenck bringing it up for the final second. Shot along the baseline is up and no good by Lindsay Hoover. Rebound to Floyd and 5 seconds to go. Long pass ahead to Rogers. She'll put up a shot as time goes out. And goes in.
Goes in at the buzzer.
87-64. Floyd County wins Saints here in the semifinals convincingly. A 23-point win for the Buffaloes of Floyd County. They remain undefeated. They go 27-0. And they move on to the championship game. It's